Hey, this is John Howell here, founder of TradingInvesting4U.com and also featured in the best-selling book, Secrets of Stock Market Trades Exposed. Now, I want to welcome you to another edition on keeping you on top of the market. So without further ado, let's get into the education. Hey, traders, this is John Howell here. And in this video, we're going to talk about some things to keep an eye out for when trading the markets. Now, if you're trading the Australian market, this doesn't apply to you. Otherwise, or you can actually take some tips and hints away from this video. This is mainly if you're trading the US market. Now, you could apply this to Australian market, but it's mainly referring to US stocks here. Now, what you're looking at right now is a company called VVUS, okay? VVUS. Now, basically what VVUS are is they're a drug company, okay? And one thing that I want to say to you is what actually happened recently is we're in a few trades here, and if I just bring this over here now so I don't have some big things moving. What actually happened was, as this market was moving here, we're in a few trades, and what ended up happening is we got into a few spread trades. Okay, if you don't know what they are, head down to Trade Investing for You, and we can help you out with understanding the terminology and so on and so forth. But if with this overall sort of VVUS trade, we got into a spread trade. But what ended up happening is it was a profitable trade overall. But what ended up happening after a couple of days is the market started going sideways, it went down again. And what ended up happening is we actually got in up here, okay? So we did a bit of a trade up around this area here, okay? And so the market was quite far away from here. We did a trade, and you know what? And it was starting to, it looked good. The trade looked good, and everything worked out well. And when expiration day came through our options trades, what ended up happening was with our options trading strategies trading. And now this is a bear call, credit spread. We're trading, and what ended up happening is that now the overall result of the trade was profitable. But I want you to that was a few days. And then what happened, 1 or 2 days after the trade was cancelled, boom, like that. That just shot up. It went from basically around about $10 up to $25 and almost close to $26 in a result of 1 day. Now, that can happen. And what ends up happening sometimes, especially when you trade in these drug companies, is they're very, very whippy. Okay, very whippy. And they're not very predictable because there's so many announcements coming out. Like just recently, what ended up happening is that there was just a small little announcement coming out from the CEO or a bunch of people from the group, and the market didn't like that, and they started getting really volatile on another particular drug company stock. So all in all, this is just a tip. This is just a bit of a hint here, and a bit of a leading guidance. I hope this is. And moving forward, I hope this helps you and lets you know that if you are trading and you're looking for predictable, movable patterns when you trade in charts in the market, and you're looking for nice patterns to trade within the market, then it's very, very important that you stay away from drug companies, okay? I cannot stress that enough. Now, if you're looking to just buy and hold with drug companies, then that's your decision. I don't believe in long-term buy and hold anymore after the 2008 stock market crash. It just shows you that even your retirement account is not looking good as well too. So all in all, what we're looking at here and what we're saying here is no matter what happens, if you're not long-term buy and hold because you fundamentally like the stock and all that sort of stuff, which again, I don't buy into at this particular time. I'm more of a trade and be strategic about the way you get in and get out. That's what I'm more about. So moving forward, I hope this helps you out. Whether you're trading the Australian market, the European market, the China market, the US market, just make sure that you keep an eye on those drug companies. And if you can, stay away from the drug companies because they are very, very volatile and they whip around so much. And before you know it, you've got a really good trade on and then you're just whipped out and you've got a really good looking trade. And before you know it, within 1 day, you're whipped out and you've made a loss for that trade. So for the last three months we've been watching this closely, and I just want to let you know that if you are trading the market and you are looking for reliable stocks, because that's what we're after, right? Us as technical analysts, as we view the charts to make our decisions to trade or not to trade, what we need to understand is we need stocks that are reliable. We need stocks that are consistently moving in a direction or are consistently producing patterns that are reliable for us to trade. That doesn't mean we're going to make money every time. There's no such thing as 100% success rate, okay? But what that does mean is you're stacking the odds on your side even more if you're sticking to stocks that are not so whippy around and they just take you out. And yes, they're giving you some good premiums, but maybe sometimes it's best to stay away from the drug company. So if you're happy trading with the drug companies, just let you know that they are very risky. They can give you good premiums, but they are very, very risky. And I hope that all in all that you do, my general advice around this is that to stay away from drug companies if you trade in the market. If you're long-term buy and hold, that's simply up to you. So I hope this helps. No matter what happens, make sure that you are doing everything you can. And these videos here and on my Trading Investing For You website, on the YouTube and all around the internet, are simply here to help you and guide you and keep you on the right side of the path of trading the markets. This is just another tip, another little hint to help you move forward. So no matter what happens, say to yourselves every morning, every afternoon, every evening, and that is success can be yours if you go claim it. So step up, take massive action, and face your fears today.
Taught by Johnny Howe, I have found that my trading skills have grown tremendously.
John Howe is truly one of the best traders of the 21st century.
John, thank you so much for all your time in helping me to become the professional trader that I have been striving to be.
And that saw me take home $1,500 Australian after expenses in only 6 trading days.
I now know I could trade on my own and be successful at it, simply because of the way John has taught me.
Over the last 5 to 6 months, we have a 70% success rate. This is amazing considering how volatile the markets are.
But at the end of January, I was in a position where I could finally test out a couple of live trades. Nothing big, not a lot of money, but on the 2 trades I put in 1 week, I was $1,200 clear. Amazing.
And my last few trades have been fantastic.
I just wanted to say thanks, John. You've got a very, very happy camper here.
I'm absolutely positive that I'm learning the necessary skills to trade the market in any condition, and I'm also earning some money along the way. And I found John's knowledge of the markets and his enthusiasm to be fantastic.
He's always available and approachable to answer any questions we have to help us get ahead.
With your phenomenal wisdom and insight into the market, you have given me the confidence to step up and take real responsibility in my trading, and the results are starting to flood in. It really means the world to me and my family, and I cannot thank you enough.
So I really have benefited so much from being mentored by Johnny and applying the techniques that he uses, and you know, his mentoring is second to none. Thanks, Johnny, you've really helped me.
John is the real deal.